Each news time, information is power. The current, the news headline. When Baba leaves office, you will hear stories like the cabal denied us access to see him. Senator Sonny, the former senator that represented the good people of Kaduna Central Senatorial Zone, Senator Shehu Sonny, has once again spoken. According to a tweet he made earlier today on his verified Twitter handle, Senator Sonny revealed what Nigerians will say once President Muhammadu Buhari leaves office in the year 2023. While speaking, he made it known that when Baba Buhari leaves power, many people will start saying different things. According to him, some will say they tried to advise him, but the cabal that surrounded him denied them access to see him and advise him. I really think that Senator Sonny made a valid point here. That is what most Nigerians always say once a president or a governor finishes his tenure. Now is the right time for them to advise him, but they will not do so. But nevertheless, we hope that one day Nigeria will be better. As far as governance is concerned and administration, you cannot rule out all possibilities. But crime is a crime. When there are criminal undertones associated with certain conduct, you cannot take away the right of the government to take steps with particular regard to ensuring that the people that are in one way or the other operating in breach are brought to book. The Attorney General of the Federation, who spoke in Abuja yesterday, said that the issue of pardon was not limited to repentant Boko Haram members, but could be extended to the serving cases. He said, generally speaking, that is why I am telling you that no possibility is ruled out. But then, there has to be an approach for the government to consider. So, I cannot be preemptive in telling you clearly and outrightly that reconciliation perhaps is being considered without an approach to be made. It is the approach to be made, if at all any is made, that we will look into for the purpose of looking at it, the authenticity of it, the good faith associated with it, and then perhaps bring about the considerable factors related to negotiations or otherwise. So, it is not a conclusion that one can outright make without juxtaposing associated facts relating to the reconciliation. You cannot conduct or operate a conciliatory approach in the blues. It is never one-sided. There has to be an approach and then a counter-concentration. So, no approach in that respect is on table for consideration yet. So, we will cross the bridge when eventually we get to that. When perhaps a type of request is made, we will then consider it on why the Mambila power project was still being held down. Malami said the remaining obstacle to the project has been removed. He said the arbitration commenced against Nigeria by Sunrise Power Transmission Company of Nigeria Limited has been discontinued. Well, for the Sunrise, perhaps one good information or perhaps the hope for celebration that I wish to present for our consideration is the fact that Sunrise has indeed withdrawn its pending arbitral proceedings in respect of which it was claiming against the interest of the federal government an amount in the region of around $1 billion. So, the information that calls for celebration is the fact that there is no pending impediment relating to Mambila project with the discontinuation of the Sunrise proceedings in Paris, the minister said. And this is the Attorney General of the Federation, Abubakar Malami, saying to the pressman that actually interviewed him that the federal government is not outlooking the using political solution in solving the case at hand, as per the self-determination agitators who had been arrested for quite a while now, that is Sunday Adeyemo Igbo of the Yoruba Nation sect that had been agitating for the freedom of the Yoruba Nation, that is the breakaway from Nigeria, and also Nnamdi Kanu of the indigenous people of Biafra, which is also a secession group who wants to break away from Nigeria. And therefore, the Attorney General of the Federation says that in this regard, that they are not saying that they do not want to make use of political solutions to solve this issue, but for the government to take this into consideration, Then a group or some group or anybody has to propose such to the federal government, and then they will look into it and see where they can actually come in after weighing the proposal. We know that the leader of the Indigenous People of Biafra, IPOB, KANU, had actually been accused of engaging in activities that can destabilize the country, where he was been charged, seven fresh count charges against him, which borders on terrorism and treasonable felony. And his trial by Justice B. Ita Inyako had yet again be adjourned to January 19, 2022, where Malami said that as well, said that as security, as far as security situation is concerned, the governance would not open their eyes and allow people, to do things that would break the country into two or breach the peace of the nation, saying that crime is a crime, and whenever there is a criminal undertone associated with particular conduct, the government needs to take steps to ensure that the people are operating in a way that is justifiable, and whatever is not, or whatever is breaching the peace of the land, those behind it has to be brought to book. The Attorney General of the Federation spoke in Abuja, saying that the issue of pardoning people was not even only spectacular to the Boko Haram members, but could be also extended to deserving cases. He said that that is why he's telling the people, the pressmen, that there has to be an approach for the government to consider, so that it is not possible for him to tell anyone clearly or outrightly that reconciliation is being considered without anyone approaching them for one. So therefore, he says that they cannot operate a conciliatory approach in the blues, that it is never one-sided, that there has to be an approach and a counter concentration, where they have to go through the approach and see the totality of it, and see if they can grant the request. And that is why the Mambila Power Project was being held down. Malami said that the remaining obstacle to the project has actually been removed. He said the arbitration commenced against Nigeria by Sunrise Power Transmission Company of Nigeria, that this particular arbitration that was against it has been discontinued. And well, for the Sunrise, perhaps one good information, or perhaps the hope for celebration that I wish to present for your consideration, is the fact that Sunrise has indeed withdrawn its pending arbitral proceedings, in respect of which it was claiming against the interest of the federal government an amount in the region of $1 billion. Thanks for listening.